Made a wrong turn once or twice. Dug my way.
Hi guys, welcome to Guide to Witchcraft episode 4, Aqua Spirit 16. And today I've been deliberating as to whether to talk to you about some pagan symbols, some of the most common pagan symbols, or some supernatural mishaps that have happened. Yeah, I mean ghosts. I see them.
Boom.
No, I'm serious, so I actually see them my whole life. I don't think I want to see ghosts, but I think that might be a bit out there. I'm a bit crazy. Some people believe me, some people don't. You can choose what to believe. But anyway, as that's as crazy as that sounds. I was staying in Supercarpation, go back into my older looking new book of shadows, and tell you about some of the most common wicca or pagan symbols. I'll start with the most common symbol, the pentacle. Now, this is obviously the most common pagan symbol, and before I started practicing, because I wasn't brought up with this religion, although my grandmother was, people told me, no, it's evil, don't draw that, it'll bring you bad luck, it's evil, it's evil, it's evil.
Yeah, no.
The Christians, I don't mean to sound bitchy or anything here, but in my opinion, the Christians have taken this symbol and made it satanic, made it represent evil, made it represent witchcraft. I mean, I have been accused of being a Satanist, of being satanic. I mean, in paganism, the wicca, there isn't even the devil. I don't believe in the devil. That is Christian, that is Catholic, it is not pagan. I mean, yes, I believe in the god, in the goddess, I believe in the stars, I believe in nature. But it is not a satanic symbol, and I've gone through so much trouble trying to explain this to people, so I prefer to do it over YouTube instead of face to face and have their smart Alex back talking comments. Anyway, now that I've had my little outburst, sorry about that, I'll read straight from my book of shadows the meaning of the pentacle. Among pagan and Wiccan symbols, the most commonly seen one is the pentagram, though most pagans, witches, or Wiccans actually call it the pentacle instead. It's the infamous five-pointed star inside a circle that seems to get so much negative attention, as I just explained to you. Though most people don't have a clue what it means or what the symbol represents, it comes to be a relatively universal symbol to represent paganism and witchcraft. A more general meaning for the pentacle is that the 5 points each represent an element, and also one of the four elements, and at the top fifth star stands for one's own spirit. The circle links them all together, illustrating how we are all part of one unity. Looking at a numerological point of view, sorry about that, getting a bit too tight again. Again, so looking at the pentacle from a numerological point of view, the 5 points of the pentacle stand for just the element earth and can be used to represent earth on an altar. The pentacle is good for element spells, and if you wear a pentacle, it is said that it will ward off evil. And take me, yeah! Now, the next symbol I have for you is, in my opinion, the next common symbol, and it is the Ankh. Now, once again, I've argued with people about this. I'm a very argumentative person, but people, no, it's an Egyptian symbol. No, it's an Egyptian symbol. Yes, it is. It is used very much in the mummification process. People sometimes call me a walking, talking encyclopedia. I'm a real nut job. I know all these really weird facts that people are like, but yes, the Ankh is an Egyptian symbol. And the Ankh is an Egyptian symbol that stands for everlasting life. Hieroglyphic images of the Ankh often show it as an object held by a loop, like a key. They don't originally a symbol that marked any particular spiritual path. It is a common symbol among pagans to show off their beliefs without the problems a pentacle or pentagram might have. It stands for life, love, and reincarnation. Thus, Egyptian, really. And you can often see the goddess Isis with it around her neck, the Ankh neck. Most animals that are used for food, whether hunted or domesticated, the male of the species most of the time has antlers or horns, thus the symbol. Also, many people have asked me about the pendant in my necklace. As I said before, I'm not brought up pagan or Wicca. My grandmother was, but on my mum's side, but my mum really wasn't brought up with it. She was brought up with believing in spirits, and my mum too can see them, but not in the religion per se. She's very open-minded, which makes it easy, much easier than my dad. But so she got me this for Christmas, thinking it was the pentacles. People ask me about it because they think, Star of David, are you Jewish? No, the symbol is actually pagan, just as the cross, the Christian cross, is actually pagan as well. It represents balance. But the Star of David represents kind of like, it's kind of like a Chinese yin and yang symbol. It symbolizes the difference between male and female. And yeah. So there you have it, a few of the most common Wicca and pagan symbols. If you ask, I will give you some more, happily. But yeah, those are the main ones. So once again, oh yes, I just remembered. I remember in my first video, I mentioned tarot cards and cartomancy. Cartomancy is pretty much just like tarot, minus the extra pretty pictures on the cards, but you can also tell your future and others' future. And I told you I'd show you how to learn it. It's very complex, actually. It's kind of hard to describe. I've read this book so many times before I could do it without it. You have to remember what the spade represents, what diamond represents, what the heart represents, and then you have to figure out how to sort them out so you can tell what the cards are trying to tell you. But it's quite funny because I do it every morning when I wake up, and it will pretty much tell me exactly what my day has in for me, exactly, down to the T. So that's kind of cool and quite useful. So I'll try to think of a way to describe that for you guys better. And please like, subscribe, and see you in my next video.